Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 101 to 125. This is the part 5 of top 300 MCQs of Indian Evidence Act 1872. Now start here. Question number 101. The content of document under section 59 of Evidence Act can be proved by oral evidence, can be not proved by oral evidence, may or may not, or here can only be proved by oral evidence and under the order of court. So here, according to section 59, so section 59 provided the all fact except content of document or electronic record may be proved by oral evidence. So all fact is proved, but content of document and electronic report not proved by oral evidence. So here answer is B is correct. That cannot be proved by oral evidence. The content of document and electronic record cannot be proved by oral evidence. This is the provision provided under section 59. Question number 102. Content of document may be proved under section 61 of evidence by primary evidence, by secondary evidence, either by primary or by secondary evidence, only by primary evidence, not by secondary evidence. So here answer is C is correct. Either by primary and or by secondary. So both type of documents is proved, either primary or secondary. Question number 103. The secondary evidence of document means a copy of document, first copy of document, oral account of content of document. Yes, both are correct here. So option C is correct here. Question number 104. Secondary evidence of document is admissible as substitute for admissibility of primary evidence. Inadmissibility of primary evidence under certain circumstances. Admissible primary evidence under all circumstances. Both A and B are correct. So in this question, here answer is admissible is primary evidence. The secondary evidence of document admissible as substitute for primary evidence. If primary evidence is not available, if primary evidence is a public document in that condition, and if primary evidence is in the custody of the opposite party, in such type of conditions the person can prove such content of document by the secondary evidence. Question number 105. The circumstance under which of the secondary evidence is admissible have been enumerated. So here answer is enumerated. Option C is correct here. Under section 65. Under section 65 is enumerated, classify the in which content in the cases, in which cases the evidence related to a document may be given as a secondary evidence. So question number 106. Secondary evidence is admissible where a non-production of primary evidence has not been accounted for. Where the non-production of primary evidence has been accounted for, irrespective of whether a non-production of primary evidence has been accounted for or not. Both A and C are correct. So in this question, answer is here. B is correct. Where the non-production of primary evidence has been accounted for. So secondary evidence is only court provided, yeah, court ordering in the place of original document, original, yeah, primary evidence, where the primary evidence is not available, yeah, the primary evidence is not produced, yeah, not produced before the court. In that condition, the secondary evidence may be proved. So question number 7. The oral account of the content of document is admissible when given by a person who has been seen and read the document. When given by a person to whom the document was read over. When given by any of the above. So here answer is, when given by a person who has seen, it is important keyword here, and read the document. The oral account of content of document only admissible by in the condition where a person who is giving the oral account of content of document seen such document or read such document. Question number 108. The document required by law to be attested can be proved under section 68. Under section 68 of evidence only. A. By calling both the attested witness, by calling at least one of the attesting witness, by calling none of the attested witness but calling some other persons and who has acknowledged that the contents, and all of the above are correct. So here answer is B is correct here. But by calling at least one of the attested witness. Section 68 provided the proof of execution of document required by law to be attested. So in that condition, at least one witness can be attested and can be proved such document is a true or false and it is genuine or not. Question number 109. The calling of at least one attested witness to prove a document under section 68 is not necessary. When document of other than a will is registered under the Indian Registration Act, when the document including will is registered under Indian Registration Act 1908, when a document irrespective of whether it is a bill or is registered under the Registration Act 1908, both B and C are correct. So question number 109, here answer is, when the document other than will is registered under the Indian Registration Act 1908. So option A is correct. Means the question is here, the calling of at least one attested witness to prove a document under section 68 is not necessary. So here answer is, if any document is registered under Indian Registration Act, there is not necessary to calling any witness. But in case of will, there is necessary to at least one witness to present to prove the content of a such document or a such will before the court. Question number 110. The will is required to be proved by calling at least one witness, attesting witness. When it is registered, when it is unregistered, when it is admitted, and all of the above. So here answer is D, all of the above. Question number 111. The public documents are mentioned in Section 72, 73, 74, 75 of Evidence Act. So here public document is mentioned in Section C, option C here, Section 74 of Evidence Act. Section 74 provides the public document provision of public document. The public document means forming by act, first point here, act or records, record of acts, and sovereign authorities, act authorities, and official body, and tribunals, act, and public officer, and legislative, judicial, and executive of any part of India, or including Commonwealth means the countries which are colonial under British rule. So these are treated as Commonwealth and or foreign country. And point number two is very important here. The public record kept in any state of private document also treated as public document according to section 74 of evidence. The following conditions and following documents are a public document. Question number 112. The document which are not covered under section 74 of Evidence Act, I already explained the public documents which are mentioned in section 74 of Evidence Act. Quasi public document, semi public document, private document, and all of the above. So here question number 12 is mentioned up the section 74. So private document is not there. So option C is correct here, private document. Question number 113. The maxim omnia presumuntur rights esse acta means all acts are presumed to be rightly done, all acts are presumed to be not rightly done, all acts are presumed to be wrongly done, all acts are presumed to be not wrongly done. So here answer is option A, all documents presumed to be rightly done. Question number 114. Admissibility of electronic record has been prescribed under. So it is answer here option C, section 65B of Indian Evidence Act. Question number 115. The principle of omnia presumuntur rights esse acta is contained in section 78 79 80 81. So here answer is section 79 of Evidence Act. So section 79 provides the presumption as the genuineness of certified copy. Question number 116. Section 79 Evidence Act apply to. So section 79 apply the option A, certificates issued by government officer, certified copy issued by government officer, other document duly certified to be genuine by government officer, all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. Certificate issues, certified copy, other documents, all things. Question number 117. Section 79 Evidence Act contain an irrebuttable presumption of law, a presumption of fact, no presumption either of fact or law. So here answer is option B, rebuttable presumption of law. Question number 118. Section 79 to 85 of Evidence Act contain the presumption of fact, rebuttable presumption of law, irrebuttable presumption of law, irrebuttable presumption of facts. So here answer is B, rebuttable presumption of law, rebuttable presumption of law. Question number 119. The presumption has to be accuracy of map and plan. Maps and plan made by authority of government contained in section 81, section 82, section 83, section 84. So here answer is section 83 of Evidence Act. Question number 120. Under section 83 of Evidence Act, presumption as accuracy of map and plans can be raised in respect of. So here important section is 83. The map and plan made by private person, map and plan made by authority of government, both A and B, and only A, not B. So here answer is B, map by made by authority of government. Option B is here. Question number 121. Due execution and authentication of a power of attorney shall be presumed under section 85 of Evidence Act when executed before and authentication by notary, judge, magistrate, all of the above. So here answer is D, under section 121, all of the above. Question number 122. Due execution of document more than 30 year old coming from proper custody is a presumption of fact, rebuttable presumption of law, irrebuttable presumption of law, presumption of fact and law. So here answer is presumption of fact. Option A is correct here. Question number 123. The presumption under section 90 of Evidence Act can be drawn in respect of original document, certified copy, uncertified copy, all of the above. So here answer is A, original document. Question number 124. The period of 30 years under section 90 of Evidence Act is be reckoned from the date on which the document is relied upon. Option B, the date on which the document is filed in the court. Option C, the date on which the document is tendered in evidence when it is genuineness document a subject of proof, all of the above. So here answer is here C, the date on which the document is tendered in evidence when its genuineness become subject to proof. Final question of this part. Section 90 of Evidence Act apply to non-testamentary document, testamentary document, both testamentary and non-testamentary document, none of the above. So here answer is both testamentary and non-testamentary document. Section 90 of Evidence Act apply both testamentary and non-testamentary documents. Thank you for watching this videos. If you like this videos, please click on like button and share this videos to your friends and relatives. Thank you for watching.